Hello everybody, today I have this 2010 Freightliner Century class. As you can see, this is the mileage of the engine. So this truck has the original engine and everything, but today I won't talk about the engine. I will talk about the shock absorbers on the front. You can see this is the original shock absorber from factory. The shock absorber is red and the frame is red because this truck used to belong to Sierra England. They used to paint everything red before when they got these trucks brand new. So as you can see, this is the original one and it has 1 million miles on it and it's still working fine. You see there is no leaks, there is nothing, there is no bushings that are loose, everything is tight, original bolts and everything. I have it right here, I already removed it. As you can see, still functional. See, it's really hard to pull out and really hard to go in, so still working fine, still functional, maybe a 60% because it's already wear all apart inside, but 60% of the shock absorber is working with no problems. It's not bad for a 1 million mile shock absorber, and this is the brand Sachs. So I will always recommend to install the original ones. In this case, for Freightliner, Sachs is the OEM shock absorber. That's right, it's so good, it's a really good brand. And as you can see, I have the new shock absorber right here. It's the same number, as you can see. It's Sachs as well. So this is the OEM for the Freightliner Century and Freightliner Cascadia too. I say then I would recommend to install these shock absorbers on the Freightliner Cascadias or Freightliners, any Freightliner model, because they last a million miles, as you can already see with these ones, and it's worth the money. I know that these are more expensive than the regular shock absorbers like Gabriel or Monroy, because this one costs around $120 and the Gabriel Monroy, they cost around 50, 40 depending where you buy it. So you wanna spend more money on two shock absorbers, but they wanna last 1 million miles, as you can see on these ones. And always when you replace the shock absorber, replace the bolts. If you want to know how to replace the shock absorbers, you can always check my video in the description below where I replace the shock absorbers on the front of Freightliner Cascadia. It's going to be similar for all Freightliner models. It's just going to vary a little depending on the difficulty and the stuff that you have to remove to replace the shock absorbers. This brand, Sachs, you can buy different types of shock absorbers. You can look at it online. You can buy a shock absorber for many different types of vehicles, not only Freightliners, but for Freightliners, these are the OEMs. But you can buy it for your Kangor, for Peterbilt and stuff like that. And they last more than the Packard if you have a Kangor or Peterbilt, because I know I've been replacing Packards in the past and they start leaking very fast. So I would recommend to use this one instead because they last long, but they're gonna be more expensive as well. First, I always go for the OEM, in this case for Freightliner Cascadias, or go for this brand if you have a different type of truck, for the Sachs, because there are the best shock absorbers I have ever seen so far. If you wonder where to get this shock absorber, you just can Google it. You can go to Google and search for Sachs shock absorbers, and you're gonna get different links and different pages where you can get this type of shock absorbers. So if you have any questions about this video, just comment below and I will try to answer them as soon as I can. If you want to send some support to my channel, you can check the video description below for details how to send support to my channel, so I can continue making helpful videos like this for everybody. So like, share, subscribe, and thank you for watching.